Hello everyone, I am Dr. A.P. Hurekar, working as a professor of mathematics in Vidya Pratishthan's Umal Nayan Bajaj Institute of Engineering and Technology, Baramati. Today we are going to study beta function. This is my lecture number 5 on integral calculus. So, in first 4 lectures, we already done reduction formulas, then rule of differentiation under integral sign, error function, as well as gamma function. So today we are going to study beta function. This will be part 1 of that and there will be part 2 also. I would like to request to all of you to subscribe channel on engineering mathematics to get latest updates and videos on it. So, integral calculus is very important branch of mathematics and many engineering and technical problems can be handled by using integration. So, integral calculus is a study in which we can learn method of evaluation of integrals, reduction formulas, gamma function, beta function, rule of differentiation under integral sign, as well as error function. It has many applications in finding area, volume, mass, mean values, root mean values, root mean square values, center of gravity, moment of inertia. It has applications in theory of probability, transforms, Laplace transform, Fourier transform, as well as in fluid mechanics. I mentioned only few areas you can find. It has applications in many more areas. So while dealing with integral calculus, most important formula that you must learn, that is integration by part. So integration of uv dx, that is equal to u into v dx minus u dash into v dx of dx. By choosing u and v, we use LIATE rule. That is, L means logarithmic function, I is inverse, A is algebraic, T is trigonometric, and E is exponential. And obviously, whichever comes first called as a u and latter is called as v. So, first function here is denoted by u and second function is denoted by v. Another important formula that we must remember while dealing with beta function, that is integration of fx dx from 0 to a, which is equal to integration of f of a minus x dx from 0 to a. So, this is also very important result. And we have to use while dealing with beta function. Most important results of gamma function. Because we know that beta and gamma function, they are very closely related. That's why while studying beta function, we must know all standard results of gamma function. Where gamma of n is integral e power minus x, x power n minus 1 dx from 0 to infinity, where n is greater than 0. Then gamma n, which can be written in alternate form as 2 times integration of e power minus t square, t power 2n minus 1 dt, limits for integration are 0 to infinity. Gamma 1 is 1, gamma 1 by 2 is root pi, gamma 0 is infinity. Gamma of p into gamma of 1 minus p is pi divided by sine of p pi, where 0 less than p less than 1. Gamma of n plus 1 is n gamma n in general, and in particular when n is natural number, it is n factorial. Then integration of e power minus kx, x power n minus 1 dx, limits are 0 to infinity. That is gamma n by k power n. So with this, we will see what is beta function. Beta function of n is defined as, notation is this, beta of mn is integration x power m minus 1, 1 minus x power n minus 1 dx, and limits for integration are 0 to 1, where condition on m and n is m is greater than 0 as well as n is also greater than 0. So, it is called as Euler's integral of first kind. We already seen gamma function of n is called as Euler's integral of second kind, whereas here beta function is called as Euler's integral of first kind. Remember, most important formula of this particular part is beta mn is given by this integral. Now, properties of beta function. Beta mn is equal to beta nm. This we can easily prove by writing beta mn standard formula is integration of x power m minus 1 into 1 minus x power n minus 1 dx. Limits for integration are 0 to 1. And we know there is one standard formula just now we studied that. That is integration of fx dx from 0 to a, which is equal to integration of f of a minus x dx from 0 to a. Here, obviously, upper limit is 1, means a is 1. So, we apply this formula over here. So, beta mn is substitute here. X is replaced by a minus x. A means 1. So, x, where there is x in this integral, we have to write 1 minus x. So, where there is x, write 1 minus x. So, 1 minus x power m minus 1. This is 1 minus of 1 minus x power n minus 1 dx. If you simplify this, we will get this 1 and plus 1 minus 1 get cancelled. So, 1 minus x power m minus 1 into this will be x power n minus 1 dx. And we can easily write, just writing x power n minus 1 first and 1 minus x power m minus 1 later. So, we can write this as integration x power n minus 1, 1 minus x power m minus 1 dx from 0 to 1. And by this definition, obviously it is nothing but beta nm. So, this is beta nm and we have got beta mn is equal to beta nm. So, remember beta mn is equal to beta nm. Prove that beta mn, second property, is 2 times integration of sine power 2m minus 1 theta cos power 2n minus 1 theta d theta, where limits are 0 to pi by 2. So, we have standard formula of beta mn. Integration x power m minus 1, 1 minus x power n minus 1 dx from 0 to 1. Now, what I have to do is, I have to write this integral in this form. So, when we want to write one integral in the form of another, what we do? We use method of substitution. So, we have to apply standard method of substitution. So, here obviously proper substitution will be x is equal to sine square theta. So, that dx will be 2 sine theta cos theta d theta. When x is 0, substitute theta will be 0 because sine 0 is 0. When x is 1, we get theta as pi by 2. So, beta mn means this integral can be written with this substitution, where there is x, write sine square theta. So, sine square theta power m minus 1, 1 minus sine square theta power n minus 1, dx means 2 sine theta cos theta d theta. Just apply substitution. And limits for integration are 0 to pi by 2. Now, we have to calculate power of sine. And 1 minus sine square theta means obviously it is cos square theta. So it is sine square theta power m minus 1. Means what is sine power? 2m minus 2. And here one more sign theta. Means sine power is 2m minus 1. This is nothing but cos square theta. And power of cos square cos theta is 2n minus 2 plus 1. Means obviously it is 2 times sine power 2m minus 1 theta, cos power 2n minus 1 theta d theta. And limits are 0 to pi by. So remember, this is another form of beta function. From that result, we can easily prove this part. Integration of sine power q theta, cos power q theta d theta, that is 0 to pi by 2, which is equal to 1 by 2 beta of p plus 1 by 2, comma q plus 1 by 2. So value of this integral can be written in the form of beta function. We already seen such integral can also be evaluated by using reduction formula. But it is more convenient if you express it in the form of beta function that you can easily observe, and it is most useful while dealing with the problems. So while doing proof, beta mn, just now we have seen it is 2 times integration of sine power 2m minus 1 theta, cos power 2n minus 1 theta d theta. And limits for integration are 0 to pi by 2. So in this result, we substitute 2m minus 1 as p, this, and 2n minus 1 as q. So m is what? If you simplify, m is p plus 1 by 2. If you solve this, you get n as q plus 1 by 2. So given integral means beta mn, if you look at this formula, just shift this 2 to other side and write down this equality in the reverse direction. So sine power from this, sine power 2m minus 1 theta, cos power 2n minus 1 theta d theta from 0 to pi by 2 is 1 by 2 because we are shifting this 2 to other side. So 1 by 2 beta of mn. And now you apply these substitutions. So integration of sine power q theta, cos power q theta d theta from 0 to pi by 2 is 1 by 2. M is what? P plus 1 by 2, comma q plus 1 by 2. So this is a most useful result again while dealing with problems. So this is a relation between beta and gamma function. Beta mn is gamma m into gamma n divided by gamma of m plus n. We already seen this result in gamma function, that is gamma 1 by 2 is root pi. Now here you can easily obtain proof of that by using formula just now we proved, that is integration of sine power q theta, cos power q theta d theta from 0 to pi by 2 is 1 by 2 beta of p plus 1 by 2 q plus 1 by 2. Put here p as 0, q as 0. So that left hand side, sine power 0 means 1, cos power 0 is 1. It is d theta from 0 to pi. And here if you substitute p as 0, you get 1 by 2. So it's 1 by 2. So it is 1 by 2 beta of 1 by 2, 1 by 2. And by using previous result, this pi by 2 I think is not required. This is typing mistake. So it is 1 by 2, gamma 1 by 2, gamma 1 by 2 divided by gamma of 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 is 1. So that's why it is gamma 1 by 2. Okay, pi by 2 is there because value of this integral, yes, it is not wrong. Because integration of d theta is theta and limits are 0 to pi by 2. So that's why we are getting pi by 2, which is 1 by 2. Gamma 1 by 2 into gamma 1 by 2 divided by gamma of 1. And we know gamma 1 is 1. So it is 2 get cancelled. Gamma 1 by 2 square is pi. So gamma 1 by 2 is root pi. So that beta mn, most important formula and result also. Beta mn can be written as integration of x power m minus 1 divided by 1 plus x power m plus n dx. From 0 to infinity. So while proving this, we will apply definition of beta function with this formula. Now, from this integral, we have to get this. Means we have to write this integral in this form. So, we have to apply method of substitution. And in this case, proper substitution will be x is equal to p divided by 1 plus t. That you have to remember. So, dx will be applying quotient rule, denominator square, that is 1 plus t whole square, denominator into partial derivative of numerator, minus numerator into derivative of denominator. So, we will get 1 plus t square, 1 plus t into 1, minus numerator is t, derivative of denominator with respect to t is 1, d. So, that gives dx is 1 by 1 plus t square dt. So, when x, if you solve this, we shift 1 plus t to other side. X into 1 plus t is t. So, what we are trying? We are trying to express t in terms of x. So, x into x t simplifies is equal to x is, shift this term to other side, yes, 1 minus x times t. Or t is equal to x divided by 1 minus x. If you solve this, you will get t is equal to x divided by 1 minus x. So, when x is 0, where we have to substitute? Okay, here. In this relation. When x is 0, obviously you will get t is 0. When x is 1, this is the best way equation I mean to say, so that we can get directly. When x is 1, denominator become 0. This anything divided by 0, that is infinite. So, when x is 1, t is infinite. Again, we required one more quantity, that is 1 minus x. So, 1 minus x means 1 minus t divided by 1 plus t. If you simplify this, that gives 1 by 1 plus t. So, beta mn, by definition is this formula. Substitute all these values, limits become 0 to infinity. X means x power m minus 1. This x means t divided by 1 plus t power m minus 1. 1 minus x means 1 by 1 plus t power n minus 1. Yes. Dx is what? 1 by 1 plus t square d. Substitute all these values. This is x power m minus 1, 1 minus x power n minus 1 and dx. And now, we will observe how many different types of terms are there. One is t, means we have to think of what is t power. And other thing is 1 plus t power. So, t power is obviously m minus 1. So, it is what? 0 to integration, t power m minus 1. Then 1 plus t power in calculate. It is in the denominator. So it is m minus 1, n minus 1, and this is minus plus 2. So what is it? M minus 1 plus n minus 1 plus 2. That gives m plus n. So if you simplify this integral, it is t power m minus 1. Divided by 1 plus t power m plus n dt from 0 to infinity. So, in the integration, you can go from one variable to another. So, substitute t as x and you will get this. So, beta mn can be written as integration x power m minus 1 divided by 1 plus x power m plus n dx from 0 to infinity. Most important useful formula as well as derivation is also very interesting. Then important results of beta function. Beta mn, this formula you have to remember. Beta mn is beta nm. Beta mn is 2 times integration of sine power 2m minus 1 theta cos power 2n minus 1 theta d theta. Limits for integration are 0 to pi by 2. Then integration of sine power p theta, cos power q theta d theta from 0 to pi by 2 is 1 by 2. beta of p plus 1 by 2, comma q plus 1 by 2. Beta mn, relation between gamma and beta function, is gamma m into gamma n divided by gamma of m plus n. Beta mn is integration of x power m minus 1 divided by 1 plus x power m plus n dx from 0 to infinity. Okay, so you have to have mastery over all these formulas so that you can easily solve problems based on these formulas. So with this now, we will go to problems of beta function. Evaluate integration 0 to 1 x power 7 into 1 minus x power 10 dx. So to evaluate this integral, we compare this integral with beta mn. So beta mn formula is this. Just compare. Limits are same. M minus 1 is 7. M minus 1 is 7. This formula we have to use. M minus 1 is 7 means m is 8. And n minus 1 is 10 means n is 11. So this quantity is nothing but given integral is beta of 8, 11. And there is a relation. Beta mn formula is gamma m into gamma n divided by gamma of m plus n. So it is gamma 8 into gamma 11 divided by gamma 8 plus 11. And we know gamma 8 is 7 factorial. Because gamma of n plus 1 is n factorial when n is natural number. And gamma 11 is 10 factorial. Gamma 19 is 18 factorial. If you solve this, 18 factorial is 18 into 17 into 16 into 15 like this up to 11 into 10 factorial. So 10 factorial get cancelled. So answer is 7 factorial divided by this one. So we can easily solve such a complicated integral just as an application of beta function. So we'll go to another problem. Evaluate integration x power 6 divided by 1 plus x power 9 dx. We have got beta mn formula, which is integration of x power m minus 1 divided by 1 plus x power m plus n dx. Limits for integration are 0 to infinity. Now compare. M minus 1, everything is same. Limits are same. Integrant is similar. This is general formula. And this is a particular case. So m minus 1 is 6, means m is 7. M plus n is 9, but m is 7, means n is what? 2. So given integral is nothing but beta of 7, 2. Beta mn. M is 7, n is 2. So given integral is beta of 7, 2. And using this formula, it is gamma 7 into gamma 2. Divided by gamma of 7 plus 2. And gamma 7 is 6 factorial. Gamma 2 is 1. And 7 plus 2 is 9. Gamma 9 is 8 factorial. If you solve this, it is 8 into 7 into 6 factorial. That get cancelled. So which is 1 by 56. Evaluate integral. Problem number 3. X power 9 into 1 minus x power 5 divided by 1 plus x power 25 dx. Limits for integration are 0 to infinity. So, we compare given integral with this standard formula. Before that, we will expand this. So, integral x power 9 1 minus x power 5 divided by 1 plus x power 25 dx from 0 to infinity is what? X power 9 divided by this quantity 1 plus x power 25, and x power 9 into x power 5 means what? X power 14 divided by 1 plus x power 25. So this integral we can write as a difference of these two integrals. Okay? So if you compare this integral with standard one, yes, what is m minus 1? M minus 1 is 9. Means what is m? M is 10. M plus n is 25. But m is 10. Means n is 15. So we have this particular first part. M is 10, n is 15. Here m minus 1 is 14. Means m is 15. And m plus n is 25. So n is 10. So this integral is nothing but beta of 10 phi mn, beta of 10 15 minus beta of 15 10. And we have got another result, beta mn is equal to beta mn. So beta of 10 15 and beta of 15 10, they are equal. So their difference is obviously 0. So value of given integral is 0. So next problem, evaluate integral x power 5 evaluate integral sin power 5 theta cos power 11 theta d theta from 0 to pi by 2. So we have this result, sin power p theta cos power q theta d theta from 0 to pi by 2 is 1 by 2 beta of p plus 1 by 2 comma q plus 1 by 2. Compare. So p means 5 and q is 11. So this integral, by applying this formula, is 1 by 2 beta of p plus 1 is 6 by 2. Q plus 1, 11 plus 1 is 12 by 2. 6 by 2 is 3. So it is beta 3 6. And beta mn is gamma m into gamma n divided by gamma of m plus n. So it is 1 by 2 gamma 3 into gamma 6 divided by gamma 9. So it is 2 factorial into 5 factorial divided by 8 factorial. If you simplify, it comes to be 2 divided by 2 factorial is 2. 8 into 7 into 6. 5 factorial divided by 5 factorial, that gives 1. So answer is 1 by 168. Okay. So with this now we go to next problem. Prove that beta mn is beta of m comma n plus 1 plus beta of m plus 1 comma n. So beta mn is gamma m into gamma n divided by gamma of m plus n. From that we can easily calculate this term, beta of m n plus 1, which will be gamma m, where there is n, write down n plus 1, gamma of n plus 1 divided by gamma of m plus n plus 1. And beta of m plus 1 n is gamma of m plus 1 into gamma n divided by gamma of m plus n plus 1. So RHS, if you consider this, which is beta m n plus 1 plus beta m plus 1 n, and these values will substitute. So it is gamma of yes, m plus, this term I have written here, it is gamma m into gamma of n plus 1 divided by gamma of m plus n plus 1, and this will be gamma m plus 1 gamma n divided by gamma of m plus n plus 1. So gamma of m plus 1, we know it is m gamma m by using reduction formula of gamma function. So it is m gamma m and gamma n as it is, denominator as it is. Gamma of n plus 1 is n gamma n. So that's why it is n gamma of m into gamma of gamma m into gamma n. So just write gamma of n plus 1 as n gamma n. Rest of the thing is same. So denominator is same. So here gamma of m into gamma of n is common. Then here we have m plus n. So it is equal to, numerator will be m plus n gamma m into gamma n. And gamma of m plus n plus 1 will be gamma of m plus n plus 1 will be m plus n gamma of m plus n by applying standard result, that is gamma of n plus 1 is n gamma n. So m plus n, which is present in numerator as well as in the denominator, that get cancelled. And we get this as gamma m into gamma n divided by gamma of m plus n, this which is beta of mn. So beta mn is beta of m n plus 1 plus beta of m plus 1 n, that is 2. So with this, now you have to do lot of practice while dealing with beta function. And for that, most important factor is you must remember all these results. So we revise whatever standard result we studied, we are going to revise. Beta mn is integration 0 to 1 x power m minus 1, 1 minus x power n minus 1 dx. Where m is greater than 0, n is also greater than 0. Beta mn is beta nm. Beta mn is equal to 2 times sine power 2m minus 1 theta cos power 2n minus 1 theta d theta from 0 to pi. Then integration sine power p theta cos power q theta d theta, that is 0 to pi by 2, 1 by 2 beta of p plus 1 by 2 comma q plus 1. Beta mn is gamma m into gamma n divided by gamma m plus n. And beta mn is integration of x power m minus 1 divided by 1 plus x power m plus n dx from 0 to infinity. So you have to do lot of practice of solving problems on beta function. As we know, practice makes man perfect. So that's why I am giving some problems for your practice. So assignment problems. Evaluate integration x power 8 into 1 minus x power 6 divided by 1 plus x power 24. And you can easily verify answer it to you. Prove that beta mn m plus 1 comma n is m divided by m plus n into beta mn. Prove that n into beta of m plus 1 comma n. I think this should be correct. Which is m into beta of m plus n. You note down all this. So I think third problem, we required some correction in the third problem. So note down, all of you note down these problems and try to solve these problems. So second one is nb, yes, nb, yes, it's nb, n times beta of m plus 1 n is equal to m times beta of m n plus 1. Okay. So with this, I would like to request to all of you to subscribe channel on Engineering Mathematics, get latest updates and videos on it. Because if you subscribe the channel, what you have to do? Exactly, you have to go to playlists. So there are different playlists. Like when you click to playlist, you will find there is an integral calculus. And in the integral calculus, at present, there are 5 lectures. Then there is a playlist on differential equation, basics of engineering mathematics, Herschel differentiation, matrices, Fourier series, multiple integral. Maybe in future there may be additional playlist. So first thing, you go to playlist and accordingly which topic you want to study or you want to watch video of this topic, you can select and you can go to playlist and accordingly select particular lecture and watch. And most important thing is you have to do lot of practice, as practice makes man perfect. So if you like this particular video, do not forget to click on like button, as well as you can give your feedback on YouTube so that I will come to know what is your opinion about these videos. Okay. So with this, I wish you all the best, happy learning, and thank you.